Hello everyone. Today I'm going to show you about transient neonatal renal medullary hypoechoic echogenicity. Terminology: temporary sonographic appearance of hypoechoic renal medullary pyramid in some normal neonates. Neonatal renal pyramids are usually hypoechoic to a renal cortex on ultrasound. Etiology unclear, not linked to increased concentration of normal dimethylphosphate glycoprotein in neonatal urine, though apparent previously has been termed dimethylphosphoproteinuria. Therefore, recent literature used descriptive term transient renal medullary hypoechoicity. Most common sign symptoms: usually asymptomatic renal insufficiency warrant search for alternative cause of increased medullary echogenicity. Age: early neonatal period, full term infant, more than premature infant. Epidemiology: incident in neonate without renal impairment around 3.9 to 37%. Renal ultrasound shows increased echogenicity of medullary pyramid in neonate with normal renal function, usually involved tip and central portion of pyramid. Base of pyramid typically remain hypoechoic. Diffusion involved of entire medullary pyramid in uncommon, may appear as layering gradient of increased consciousness brightness at tip of pyramid. Posterior acoustic shadowing is type called absent. Bilateral more than unilateral renal involvement. Segmental involvement sparing of some medullary pyramid more than diffuse involved of all pyramid. No more renal cortical echogenicity and sounds. Increased echogenicity of renal medullary pyramid usually results spontaneously by tending. This is ultrasound, so a lot more right in the first right kidney in the first day old girl. The neonatal period, the medullary pyramid are no more hypoechoic compared to the renal cortex. Also note the normal fetal lobation. Again, ultrasound of black kidney in the neonate on the first day of life, so increase echogenicity at the tip of multiple renal pyramid. The medullary increased echogenicity has a result on the repeat ultrasound 1 month later. Ultrasound in the newborn, so increased echogenicity in all renal pyramid. Note the extensive involvement of individual pyramids with a gradient of echogenicity that is most pronounced at the tip and less so in the central portion. Only the base of pyramids have a normal hypoechoic apparent. Ultrasound in a newborn, so this creates a foci of increased echogenicity at the tip of two medullary pyramids. While other pyramids have a normal hypoechoic apron. Renal ultrasound in a newborn show increased sequentiality of all the renal pyramid with no posterior acoustic shadowing. The increased sequentiality involved the tip and central portion of the pyramid sparing the base. Ultrasound of the left kidney in a neonate with normal renal function on the first day of life. So that the tip and central portion of multiple renal pyramid are hypoechoic. 1 month later, the pyramid have a normal hypoechoic appearance. Treatment, usually no need any treatment. Thank you.